Welcome back a million to my channel of Aspie Answers, or to the podcast of Aspie Answers, which will be live hopefully soon. For the series that I'm introducing to you all today on autism, and especially this series all about it, so you can get to know more. As I said, I'm here to share more about this because I want to raise an awareness and understanding based on these conditions as well as mental health. And that for those of you who are new to my channel or even on my podcast, just a quick brief interjection before I begin my topic today. I'm Aspie Answers, as your host, your advocate, navigator that's navigating through life with autism and mental health of her own life experiences, knowledge and know-how. As well as saying this, I'm hoping to do some fun and games along the way, as I usually do for you guys, to entertain you all, to take a break from certain topics that I do. But as I said, I'm all about inclusion and not exclusion. So if you're into any of these, feel free to smash that subscribe button on the bottom right hand corner of the screen, or if feel free not to also follow me on my social medias, because usually sometimes I'll post some of these via through the medias that will pop up of my Twitter and Instagram mainly, as well as mentioned in my podcast. And don't forget also, if you did decide to join me on the bandwagon to be on as part of the YouTube family of mine, feel free to also turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any future updates, because usually I try to aim to post every day Monday to Friday, but as I said, this may subject to change. This will be much appreciated from you all to support me in any way you can. So I must admit that autism is a very complex neurodevelopmental and developmental disorder, or shall we say condition, that affects different people on the autism spectrum or in different ways. As I said also, I can't stress it enough that not autistics are all the same, because there is a spectrum of autism, which you'll see in above me about that autism spectrum umbrella to understand more about the different types. As well as in saying this, I've also talked about the different types of autism, which you can see in the archive above me also, as well as in the description box with the timestamp on it. And in saying this also, again, there'll be an illustration floating about with Aspie explaining the terminology, how spectrum comes about, to gain a better understanding. Autism is known as many forms of different differentiations of meanings or clinical meaning, shall we say, to others, which I did share briefly based on this. Also, I'll link in the iCard and in the description box below me, so you can gain a better understanding to what this is all about based on my understanding, knowledge and experience. Because obviously there has been so much conflicting information about autism out there, so that's why I'm here today to give you guys the lowdown of my knowledge, experience and research based on this and so much more. It can be a difficult topic, or just difficult to understand in general, basically, of the such nuisance kind of topic that I'm addressing to you all today, especially with all the conflicting information of autism that is out there. With the increasing amounts of autism diagnoses around the world these days, it's more important than ever to have a good understanding of it and know what autism is truly is, based on the whole entire meaning. And also, just maybe when you meet an autistic, ask them what autism is like for them. And you gotta remember that in saying this, with this basic understanding, is about knowing how to be right fitted of how to help an autistic in a way of whoever it may be it your family member, your friend, your brother, sister, or what have you. You may ask yourself though, what if an autistic act normal? But then again, my question is, what is normal? Normal is underrated these days. How would you define as normal to you? I would like to ask you this while you are thinking, or maybe asking this to yourself, about that very question. Yes, there are some autistic people, I'll admit, that can pass as normal people, or in this case, non-autistic slash, as many of us will call ourselves, neurodivergent versus the neurotypical world. What might make one autistic person melt down may not bother another person. Some people have been taught basic to hide their autistic traits very well, like not stimming or forcing themselves to make the everyday eye contact that you guys would like us to do. Even though, as I said before, I made a topic about why, you know, eye contact is hard for autistic people, which I'll link in the iCard above me and in the description box below me, to gain a better understanding to why this maybe is for those of you who are new. Feel free to view that anytime. And some have autistic traits that aren't usually easily visible, seen through the naked eye, here say, like your sensory issues, or surprisingly some rigid routines that some of us come about. These are just a few majority of us autistic that will pass as normal in your eyes, due to us having to also mark and mimic the everyday behaviors and attitudes from others, thinking and assuming that this is the way of everyday living, obviously. And in the same as that, by us mimicking and copying from people that we're socializing with, thinking this is how we should be talking, thinking, acting, dressing up, and what have you. This can be tiring and damaging to all of us autistics alike, as this can have dire effects on our mental health. I did share a little bit about masking, which you can click also above me and in the description box below me. There's also quite a lot of pressure on autistic people these days, especially those who don't need a lot of support to act neurotypical. So it's entirely possible for autistic people to not seem autistic to you guys, though this isn't something you should say to them, since it's really hurtful and cruel sort of thing. It's it's like an ableist comment that you're gonna thrash about, but how you might be or talk to us will come across as you guys being ableist, which I have said about ableism, which I'll link in the iCard above me and in the description box. If you're not sure if someone needs help, it's perfectly okay to ask them, because we are willing to actually share with you all what we need at that given moment of time, as long as it's appropriate, just to bear in mind basically of that moment. Also, with many autistics, especially for us females, many of them will mask their feelings, as I said, and thoughts, no matter what it is, just to blend in and fit into today's norms, expectations, realistic values and what have you, with the neurotypicals or neurodivergence, as I mentioned. Again, as a friendly reminder, but if you meet one autistic, be sure to ask them questions and what they want and to be called, especially because obviously each to their own of a label. I have mentioned how to address a talk in the autistic community, which I'll link in the iCard in the description box below me. And be sure also, in saying this as a friendly reminder, involve the person who is autistic in your everyday activity, as you'll be surprised on what you may see or try to be in our shoes to see what the world is like for us. I'm going to break this down into three parts right now. So part one is doing your own research. These manuals will give you a general sense of what autism is like, although they don't go into great detail. Now they're trying to make it into great detail of how autism has come about. It can be a helpful starting point, however, and understand the basics of autism. The definition doesn't completely fit everybody. Every autistic person is different. Some autistic people may have problems with, again, sensory processing disorders, while others don't. Some autistics may communicate non-verbally or with an AAC, a special kind of tool that helps them. It's like a voice activated kind of tool that is maybe of a software that is installed into a tablet or what have you, to help the non-verbal autistics to communicate in a way so that you guys can understand them, which I have actually addressed how to talk to a non-verbal autistic somewhere, which I'll link in the iCard and in the description box below me, so you can gain a better understanding also. While others communicate verbally, however, and may have a rather large sophisticated vocabulary for their age. If you know an autistic who doesn't fit in all this diagnostic criteria, though, don't forever assume they are lying or faking it. Autism is a spectrum disorder, so not everyone has a piece of it. I also have heard about the DSM-5 on how it comes about in New Zealand, and I'm hoping to do a more in-depth one later today. Not every source is credible, however, and not every source that claims credibility is a good one. So therefore, find a website or any resource that is a trusted source by talking to some advocates that are autistics for autistic. Articles written without feedback from any autistic people may get things wrong, such as a classic one, Autism Speaks, which I have shared why people are against this hate group of Autism Speaks, which I'll link in the iCard in the description box below me. That's obviously just briefly, though. Autism Speaks is an example of a nation that spreads inaccurate information. For example, the myth that vaccines causes autism. Parents of autistic children or teens may get information wrong as well. It's just human nature. Remember, just being related to an autistic person doesn't make the person an expert of autism or on autism. Particularly if the parent complains about how the autistic child makes it so they can't do anything they enjoy. Now that they wish their child wasn't autistic or anything similar, they likely don't have a good understanding of autism. Autistic people have lived with autism for most of their life or all of their life, depending on what age they got diagnosed and everything else, because as we know, autism is known for as a supposedly a long time ago a male diagnosis, but now many females are getting misdiagnosed, hearsay. So therefore, I have shared basically this about the woman on the autism spectrum and whatnot, which I'll link in the iCard in the description box below me. Usually, basically, with the ones that has had autism in their lives, basically have the clearest picture of what is going on inside their own head. Their personal accounts can give you a glimpse into the minds of real autistic people, such as Cynthia Kim, Amy Squinsnier, Ido Keita, Amelia Big, Emma Jutcher Long, and Kirsten Sibley are also good examples of autistic writers, just to name a few out there. ASAN, the Autism Woman and Non-Binary Network, and others have writers who know a lot about autism. These organizations can help with many things, whether it's dispelling the rumors or myths or misconceptions about autism, advertising any events that are in support of autism acceptance, or simply just giving a perspective on some given topic based through the autism perspective of what life is like for them. These organizations may talk about painful subjects from time to time also, such as abuse of an autistic or other disabled people. If you feel like you are unable to handle hearing about those kind of subjects, you should avoid them if need be. Autism as I said, was previously sorted into subcategories including PPDNOS or atypical autism, Asperger's syndrome, and classic autism. Since the distinctions between each category has been unclear, however, the DSM-5 and the ICD-11 now simply uses the label autism spectrum disorder. The ICD-10 still refers to these subcategories, though in areas where the ICD is more commonly used than the DSM. You may hear these old labels being used, however, some people may use the term Asperger's to refer to autistic person who appears to need less support or who didn't display certain signs in early childhood, such as speech delays. While some people use functioning labels such as high functioning versus the low functioning to describe an autistic person, many autistic people actually dislike these labels, which I have actually clearly mentioned about the problems with the functioning labels of high functioning versus the low functioning, which I'll link in the iCard as well as some other topics based on the in the description box below me as well. It is impossible to define someone's exact needs, strengths and weaknesses by using this functioning label. It's best not to use them in favour of describing the person's strengths and weaknesses instead. Autism really comes alone, as we know, because obviously it comes hand in hand with some sort of other condition. Some could be learning disabilities such as ADHD, ADD and whatnot, and then it can come into also the mental health realm of maybe bipolar versus everything else. So you or your loved one's symptoms may not be only caused by autism alone. As I said, research has concomitant conditions so that you can distinguish between autism and other things. Also, many conditions do correlate to autism with similar symptoms and signs as well, as I mentioned, such as your sensory processing disorders, very often co-occurs with autism though, epilepsy, seizures, gastrointestinal issues, anxiety disorders, depression, ADHD, oppositional defiant disorder, dyspraxia. This is a well-known thing, obviously, because in the autism diagnostic criteria, this has been improved over time, leading to more people receiving an accurate diagnosis. Studies have shown that the rate of autism in children is about the same rate in adults alone. Studies have shown also that basically in saying this about the differences in survey questioning wording may also suggest the higher rate. Keep in mind though that autism isn't a disease, a disability is not an epidemic. The term epidemic is most often used to describe diseases. Saying that there is an autism epidemic can be hurtful to the people on the autistic community. Autistic people learn and grow just like non-autistic people do. They simply learn a different, often lopsided pace, however. An autistic girl will do much more capable at the age of 14 than she was maybe at age 4, and even more capable at age 24. Don't listen to people who say your autistic child will never ... because obviously they're showing signs of ableism. Obviously, there's no way to know this for sure. People can only take things step by step. This is the term called ableism, and that is sure as how real today and it exists. Obviously, I mean, as again mentioned about ableism, which I'll link in the iCard or in the description box below me, so you can follow me through this to find out more. So, because autism is very clearly not caused by vaccines. I've mentioned about autism and vaccines, or vaccine doesn't cause autism somewhere in one of my videos, which I'll link in the description below me also, so you can gain a better understanding. Despite celebrity claims, the single study that found a link was found to be fraudulent. Its author, Andrew Wakefield, was attempting to market his own vaccine. He skewed the data, hoping to profit. The study was retracted, his license was revoked, and many studies have since been proven his wrong. Vaccines were invented in 1796 and may have prevented and even eradicated dangerous diseases such as smallpox and other things, such as controversially the claim that the MMR vaccine causes autism that was made in 1998 and was retracted by the year of 2004. This is a well-known one. I've heard this on some of the autism community groups are based on this. Like the refrigerator mother myth, which suggested that a lot of mothers caused autism, have been debunked. Autistic people can be born to wonderful parents as well as terrible ones. Many parents love their autistic children dearly. On the flip side, autism will not be erased by the effects of a warrior parent. A parent who pours all their energy into various therapists and treatment. Negligent parents may lead to reactive attachment disorder, RAD, which shares some traits with autism, which is completely different. So don't mistake RAD for autism. Some autistic people have enormous IQs while others have severe intellectual disabilities. Many autistic people are around average intelligence. Just like non-autistic people, autistic people exist at all levels of intelligence. An autistic person will not only be an expert on math, science, English, or what have you, even if they do have that high IQ level. Autistic people being mathematical thinkers is a stereotype and isn't always true. Some autistic people are bad at mathematical or scientific topics, but they can be incredible at other ones such as language. Some autism groups use scare tactic to fundraise, and this may point an overly negative picture of autism. Example, claiming that 80% of parents divorce, which is clearly untrue, obviously, because this is what autism speaks does of the hated group. Autistic people are capable of smiling, having fun, and loving their own family. Autistic people can live a happy life and be autistic at the same time. Being autistic is not a sentence to a dark, doomy, gloomy life of doom and gloom. We have basically been told that we're maybe robotic, we have monotones and all that, you know. Some autistic people may appear, you know, feeling like they don't show their emotions, feelings, or what have you, but this may be due to thoughtfulness, alexithymia, which is difficulty in understanding emotions, or withdrawal due to being overwhelmed. Some autistic people describe themselves as having too much empathy, and we are known as empaths when we have too much empathy. So it's like, again, a 50-50 balance between this. While others qualify that they struggle to understand others' thoughts, but feel very intensely. Autistic people often feel very distressed when they see someone else upset. It has been well known that many people think people that are autistic are less likely to commit violent crime than the general population, and they are more likely to become the victims of bullying and violence, though on the other side of the coin. If an autistic person is acting violent or aggressive, it may be due to an underlying issue, not just their autism in general. Autism children may act aggressive due to abusive therapies or build up frustration, especially if they can't speak and haven't been given maybe an AAC to talk with. This is a panic self-defense response and isn't premedicated. Autistic people feel greater distress than non-autistic people do. As I said before, many of us are empaths and we feel deeply when they see someone who is upset. However, they are less able to understand what other people are thinking. So therefore, again, this will be nice if, for example, if you're not feeling the right way, can you please, maybe as an autistic myself, be honest and open up to us and know what you're thinking or feeling, so that we can actually not make the assumptions of what's going on around you or what have you, so that it doesn't cause a disagreement between you and myself if I was involved in that formality. So then hopefully it doesn't come up to just certain conflicts and disagreement. This means the autistic people may be socially clueless and do something upsetting without even realizing it as well, though. Despite the 8-year-old white boy stereotype, autistic people can be of any gender, age, race. Autistic people are a diverse group. Autism is lifelong, so it will be with us for life. An autistic child will grow into an autistic adult. Anyone who claims they can cure autism isn't being honest with you. Not everyone is diagnosed in childhood, however. As I said, some may be diagnosed into their teens or adult life. Sometimes they are diagnosed after their children are diagnosed. Autism tends to be overlooked in people who aren't white and male. Doctors tend to focus on how symptoms typically present in white males, so diagnosis may be harder for girls and people of color. Studies have shown that autistic people feel afraid when they may make eye contact, and autistic people report it's painful and really distracting for them to try and make an eye contact as long as they can to withhold a conversation. Many may look somewhere else when listening, but it doesn't forever mean, as I said, that they're, you know, ignoring the speaker as they're speaking to you, because obviously as I said, that we are listening, we're absorbing all the information, even if we are lacking in that eye contact department, even though we do communicate in other means of ways of our body language as well. Autistic people may speak with unusual tone, volume, speed, and or pitch. Again, this is another topic I have spoken about, basically. They may repeat words, phrases, or songs, which is known for as echolalia. They may speak in a highly abstracted and artistic manner. Autistic people may have one or two or even more deep passions that they like at one given moment of time. An autistic person can spend a very long time engaged with that topic and can recite a long info dump, if you will, if you want to call it that, of information to others. Special interests can fade, change, and be created over time. However, sometimes an autistic person may go through some time with no special interest whatsoever. An autistic person feels very passionate about their interests. They may become so hyperactive as well as also talented in that given area of interest. Parents encourage the developmental of that interest at heart if need be. Some special interests can be people, whether they are in a romantic interest or not as well. The person can be a celebrity or someone that the autistic person actually knows. The autistic person may be interested in learning everything about the be devastated if they know each other. and they lose confidence. Well, just the people are often sincere, saying exactly what they mean and expecting others to do the same too. They may struggle with understanding figurative language and sarcasm, however, and knowing whether someone is joking or not. Again, this is another video about all about sarcasm and more, which I'll link in the description box below me. Autistic people can become overwhelmed with unpredictability and too many decisions to make on their own. However, providing a clear routine can help them by keeping a daily task from becoming too taxing for them. An autistic person will often become distressed and overwhelmed if their routine is disrupted. To add structure to each day, try writing out a schedule with everything the autistic person will be expected to do on that day, however, when and what have you. If the person is younger or if they don't read, you might use pictures or the schedule rather than work. An autistic person may struggle with some or all aspects of executive functioning, which I'm one of them, hence why I do lists and tables or what have you just to help me with my memory. I have talked about my hacks and whatnot on how I go about it, which I'll link in the card or description box below. Executive dysfunction is a complicated issue and may include disorganization, poor impulsive control, difficulty getting started on a task, trouble focusing, or difficulty in self-monitoring themselves. Autistic people may learn different things at different speeds, such as learning to read chapter books before learning to speak in structured sentences. Their social development may be particularly slow as well. Some autistic people learn to speak late, some are unable to speak. Some autistic children meet their milestones later than average, leading to a diagnosis. Others meet them early or out of order. Some meet them in order and may be diagnosed at a later life. Teens and young adults may also meet later life milestones, such as driving, getting a job, or moving out. Autistic people might find it hard to start and maintain conversation, read body language, and understand what other people are thinking, making friends, and handle large groups of people, which I have talked about how to make friends with an autistic person or vice versa, which I'll link all these in the description below me. Social situations can be embarrassing or awkward for an autistic person. Autistic people may not be able to pick up an unwritten social rule. They may need to be taught explicitly. Introversion is quite common with autism. Some autistic people are content with few friends while others want to make more friends. I don't forever assume that just because like we are struggling with this weakness of socialization, we would love to maybe make friends and keep friends. But then again, as I've learned as I'm getting older, that you know there are people that come in our lives to teach us the good and bad and everything else. That quota, sometimes we have to have a smaller circle obviously just to do our own thing, because obviously we need to determine who's there for the long haul. But bear in mind though, when we want to make friends, maybe some of us will struggle not knowing how to, you know, make friends. Like other skills, social skills can be learned in practice. However, sometimes autistic people can be treated poorly by their peers due to the problems they may have with their social skills. Misunderstanding figurative language, saying inappropriate things at the bad time, not understanding when somebody needs cover to be left alone or what have you, and so on and so forth, can cause an autistic person to have trouble with social relationships. Autistic people may walk on their toes and stim. An example here is making fidget motions that may be subtle or unusual to you as a normal person. Examples of stimming may include flapping of hands, tapping feet, playing with their hair, rocking, humming, and flicking their fingers. Stimming can help autistic people feel calm and stay focused on what they're doing. Stimming shouldn't be stopped entirely, as I said, because obviously needed for us. It's just like another classic example of what I've been researching also for people that has Tourette's, that they need to let out their they can't withhold them and whatnot because it can be really tiring. If an autistic person stims is distracting you or others or is inappropriate for the situation that you're at right now, you know, basically it's okay to ask them to switch to another stim, but not ask them to stop the stimming entirely. And never restrain them if they won't stop stimming whatsoever, because that can be really more harmful than good. Preventing someone from stimming can lead to psychological harm. Most autistic people may have sensory processing disorders in which some of their senses, sight, smell, touch, taste, and what have you, basically are over or under responsive. They might cover their ears when they hear a vacuum, pitch their nose at the smell of a spice, or rub things because they love the texture of some given material. An autistic person may love noise and have headphones on all day, but may not eat certain foods because of the feel and taste of it. These may happen when an autistic person becomes overwhelmed by stress and can no longer cope. These are not done on purpose, however. Meltdowns will, for example, to gain in a better understanding, are very different from those that are throwing fits or tantrums. The autistic person should be helped away from the situation rather than being punished or scolded whatsoever. So don't forever yell at them if they are having a meltdown in public view, because it has happened to me a few times, me having a meltdown, and I'm trying my hardest to withhold it, but then I get told not to withhold my meltdowns. If it happens, it happens. I've seen a meltdown, all these other bits that happens to me, be it a shutdown, also can happen when an autistic brain can't process things and may stop being able to do tasks like cleaning up, talking, driving, etc., etc., and this may vary from time to time of a given situation or environment they're in that causes this meltdown, shutdown phases, which as we know, basically, though, however, with this being said, the autistic person may become very passive and may look sad or emotional. Sensory overload is caused by an overwhelming environment. The only cure or method for this is time and a quiet place for us to rest and recover from. One autistic person may not have every symptom that I've listed on one of the listings, and this is quite normal. Each autistic person will have their own individual personality abilities and needs, as well as their strengths and weaknesses and what have you. Don't forever assume that autistic people are all the same, as I can't stress this enough, because they're not, and meeting multiple autistic people will prove that to you on a given daily. So in saying this, is just basically, you need to accept us for who and what we are, despite this label of autism and what have you. And that in saying this, that hopefully that you can see from our point of view versus our world of difference of what we see, which I clearly share my story based on how I see the world on a chapter called World of Differences. So this quickly wraps up basically how to understand autism or understanding autism. Smash that like if you like this. Comment below if you're autistic and want to actually share your opinions on this, about how you want people to understand you as an autistic, you know, maybe some tips and advice about it, so that hopefully we can open the discussion, because obviously, as I said before, I'm open for discussion with you guys. Don't forget to follow me on my social medias as it comes up, as well as also feel free to actually do what you will, what I'm about to share with you all. Also, where to find me? Spotify, obviously, is Aspie Answers, which is capital A, capital A. Patreon is my crowdfunding page right now. You can find me on patreon.com, Aspie Answers, basically. And for those of you who don't know what Patreon is today, for those who are listening that are new, I have this set up for funding for future projects like this one of my podcast versus my merch that I've been designing. It's like a crowdfunding page or funding page for creators like me, or content creators, music creators, whoever it may be that's seeking out funding to support themselves in a way of maybe, say, they need extra equipment for their cameras versus maybe their radio equipment if they were doing something similar like I am doing today, or covering their rent, travel costs, what have you. And so, in saying this, my merch site is spreadshirt.com life-of-an-sb. Feel free to become a patron to support this future project, as well as many others that are in the works as of this time. Feel free to, you know, donate big or small with me in this journey of it. And also my merch obviously will cover the cost for this as well. So I'll catch you all again on the other side. Aspie signing out for now, and bye.